Welcome back. Today we have a Longines pocket watch. Usually the watches I find at flea markets are in terrible shape, but this one surprisingly is in good shape. I looked up the serial number for this watch, and it said it was produced around 1919. This is an ad from the same time period. Pocket watches at this time were usually sold just by the movement, and then you would pick out a case. So you would walk in a jewelry store and pick out your movement, and then you would pick out the case you would want it in. The movement looks to be in really good shape for the age. It'll probably just need a service and that's it. First thing we're going to want to do is let the power down. Then we're going to proceed to take it out of the case. Pocket watches are a breath of fresh air compared to wristwatches. It's fun to see how jumbo the parts are compared to when you do a vintage ladies' watch. Thank you. Even without any power, this watch is dying to run. The caliber on this watch is an 18.89. You can see that it is 21 jewels, which is pretty high for the time. 17 was the standard. The steel plate on the pallet fork is really high quality, as is the screwed-on chatons. The escape wheel is capped, so we're gonna have to take off the chaton. You need to be careful working with tiny screws, because if you put too much pressure down, you can go right through the threads. A lot of vintage Longines calibers have the ratchet wheel under the barrel bridge, which is a harder thing to manufacture. Usually you see a lot more problems with watches at this age. I don't think I really have to fix anything on this. Here's a complete watch, all disassembled. The only thing to do before cleaning is to take out the mainspring. Mainsprings in pocket watches are pretty strong, so the tweezers aren't going to cut it in this case. Time to assemble it all again. I'll be starting with assembling the barrel. The next step is we're going to oil all the capsules. This is the upper capsule for the balance. What's neat about the old pocket watches is they would stamp the bottom of the bridges, as you can see. That correlates with its serial number. There's a close-up of the oil in the jewel. And now we'll oil the upper escape wheel cap jewel. I won't show the lower ones just for the sake of the time of the video. Then we'll move on to the setting components. The setting components transfers the energy from the crown to either winding the watch or setting the watch, depending on if the crown is in the first position or second position. It's always interesting to see how each watch designs their setting components. Usually each caliber has its own design, but primarily they all function the same. Now we're going to add the parts that's underneath the barrel bridge. You put a lot of stress on the winding components, so you want to make sure you oil them appropriately. Now we're going to assemble the gear train, which is my favorite part. I always try to start at the escape wheel and work my way up to the barrel. Every caliber is different though, and sometimes it's not the best way to do things. Now we're going to oil the gear train. And now the other side. A steel-capped pallet bridge really isn't necessary, but it does give it such a nice look. And just like the chatons, it's a nice marking of high quality. Now that the pallet's in place to hold the gear train, we're going to wind the watch to full. We're gonna add the balance and hope it works. This is the initial timing on it. It's really not too bad. But now it's a lot better. Here's a few close-up shots. It's a really nice looking movement, and it's been relatively easy to work on. We're just going to add the last of the components on the dial side, then we'll dial it up. Enamel dials are great because they're really easy to clean. I usually just use soap and water with a toothbrush. Thank you. And we're going to throw the case in the ultrasonic. Let that sit for a little bit. Now that we got all the dirt off, I'm gonna buff the case. The case is plated, so I'm just gonna use a buffing compound on microfiber, and that'll just shine it up a little bit. It won't take out all the scratches, but it'll shine it up. I also replaced the crystal to a new dome mineral glass crystal. I love the look of this case. It has intricate carvings on the sides and it's white gold, which usually you don't see, usually it's yellow gold cases. Now that we got that all prepared, we can install the dial. Next, we're going to add the hands. The whole look of this watch is very elegant. The blued steel hands with the classic enamel dial just makes it pop. Now it's time to case it up. It's a little hard to show that part, so please excuse my filming. And that's pretty much it. This one went really easy and it came out really nice. I think this watch serves as a perfect example of what great craftsmanship Longines did back in the day. This watch will be available for sale on my Etsy page in the description. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe if you want to see more.